I love the spiral, of course. There's a pattern to life. You keep repeating a certain cycle. You know, it's different characters, different scenarios, but the root of it all is still the same. And it's how you keep evolving through that pattern. A friend of mine needed a haircut. I was 12 years old, he was about 15. Wooly Woo, God bless the dead, that's my dude. He was going out to meet this girl. Didn't have enough money to take her out to the movies. He was only gonna take her to see She's Gotta Have It. First year that came out. It was his birthday and his grandmother gave him $100. And he ended up buying the Jordan 1s with that money. So he barely had enough to get a haircut after that and take her out. So he was just like, yo, G, can you just shave my sides bald? He had his pops clippers. I'm like, all right, let's go. You know, I used to sit in barber shops and watch a lot and sweep sometimes and all that. And I kind of like felt like I knew what to do instinctively. So I just like went and got a comb, started blending them out and everything. By the time I was done, he was like, yo, you my barber, you can keep those clippers. From there, boom. I was cutting the block, the whole neighborhood, and traveling back and forth from Brownsville and East New York, from my mom's and my grandmother's crib and all that. And, you know, just a knapsack with a composition book in it, a pen, and some clippers, you know, just cutting people's hair in their crib for $5. That moment after the cut, when they looking in the mirror and they're like, yo, they feeling right. You could see it in their face. You know, you can't really even put monetary value on that, you know. It travels, you know. So that's why when I cut people's hair, you know, I don't really charge them. I have a box. I just put what you can in there or what you feel, you know? And because no matter what, I'm going to give you 100% of me. Because when you walk out that door, I'm walking out that door with you, you know? So that's really important for me. I worked from home for 7 years. I used to have a shop back out in Queens for a while. My family and I separated. You know, and that was really a different path that I didn't expect in my life. And my mother had passed away, and this was all within a short frame of time. So it made me like really evaluate what was going on. Who am I? What do I want? What makes me happy? So I just kind of reversed everything and went back to why I do this. So for 7 years, I just stayed. I would just work from my home studio. And from there, I kind of like cultivated what I want to do and who I want to engage, you know, and got back into tune with who I am and how that's being expressed through my craft. I always wanted to come back to where I began. You can gentrify your own community. The streets that's making it bad or the buildings and all of that, it's the mentality that we choose to go live in this space with, you know? And we can change our mind and change our environment and literally recalibrate everything that's around us and engage our own people and ourselves, you know? And we don't have to run.